My name is Pratik, and welcome to my talk regarding content testing for QBs. To begin with a professional introduction, I am a project manager with Red Hat, and I would like to begin by telling you a few things about myself. Now, you may be wondering why a project manager is talking about content testing, especially for quality engineers. Well, I speak from my experience, and the experience being that I've been a technical writer, or rather, I was a technical writer for more than 7 years until last year. I switched over to my new profile as a project manager starting Jan 2020. Speaking of January 2020, I hope you and your loved ones are doing safe and well in these unusual circumstances that we are facing globally. That being said, that's my professional introduction, and I'd like to tell you a few things about me on a personal level. I am a huge adventure enthusiast, and when I say huge, I might not be the biggest one, but I like adventure sports a lot, and so far I've had my fair share of adrenaline rushes with bungee jumping, flying fox, paragliding, river rafting, scuba diving, just to name a few of them. Well, apart from that, I'm also a binge eater and a watcher. Most of my weekend I usually spend on the couch eating junk food and watching TV shows starting from Archer on FX to anything supernatural or so. That being said, I'd like to also tell you about my usual day. I usually start off by waking up early in the morning, say 6:30-ish to 10-ish. That's early for me. I try to survive the entire day. Then I go back to sleep, and that's pretty much a question mark after that. I usually try to repeat it, even though I don't want to, but that's what my weekdays are like. Here's a fun fact about myself. This is my first time presenting virtually, and I'm pretty sure I'm going to spend a lot of time trying to make and edit this video, which you all are seeing. But speaking of videos, I just thought it would be fun for us to watch a video within a video, you know, a video session of sorts. That being said, I promise that the video that we're watching is going to be relevant to the talk. So here we go. And we're back. As you can see, incorrect instructions, or perhaps you can call it a situational misunderstanding, can be very, very dangerous. I hope everyone liked this video. And that being said, let's continue on to the next part of our presentation. I would like to tell you all a very small story. A very small story about a person named Ralph. What is Ralph, or who is Ralph? This is Ralph. Ralph is a concept created by you while reading this. And when you stop, Ralph ceases to exist. Your attention, your mere attention, is the barrier between Ralph and the entire void. And Ralph is sure to say he's scared. So, can anyone think, where is Ralph? Well, we might think that Ralph is just a cartoon character, something that we're thinking about and doesn't exist anymore. Yes, that is true. But where was Ralph when we were thinking about him? Ralph was in our attention span. Now, talking about attention span, okay, according to a recent study, the average attention span for a human being in 2020 is the same as that of a goldfish. Can you believe that? Yes, that is true. Human beings in 2020 have the attention span of a goldfish, which is absolutely, according to scientists, 9 seconds. Can you believe that? Just 9 seconds of an attention span is what we are looking at a human being, at an average human being, averaging in the year 2020. Now, let's see how well our attention span is with just this quick 2 checks. Okay, what I'm going to be doing is presenting you 2 different cases. In each case, you'll have to read a small piece of content in under 15 seconds and come up with the answers to 2 questions related to that content. Now, if you remember, We are looking at an average time attention span of 9 seconds. However, for these activities, we'll be taking across 15 seconds. All right, so let's start with the first one. So let's begin with check A. The rules are pretty simple. You have 15 seconds and you have a piece of content that you need to look at in those 15 seconds. After the 15 seconds are over, I will show you two questions and you will have to come up with answers to those questions. And your 15 seconds start now. And that's 15. All right. So can you come up with answers to these two questions looking at the content that you've read in the past 15 seconds? Now, the first question is, how many architectures does OSA support? If you've come up with the answer 4 or 5, that is correct. On the other hand, the next question, what is the size of the ISO file for OSA? I'm pretty sure nobody could come up with an answer because that piece of information is missing from this content. Now, let's introspect quickly. Were you able to go through the content in under 15 seconds and able to answer the questions, both of them correctly? If not, it's absolutely fine. Now, let's look at a similar situation, but in a different way. Okay, now let's do check B. The rules, once again, are very simple. You have 15 seconds to look at a piece of content and answer two questions related to it. And here we go. And that's 15. Now, are you able to answer these two questions? Does OSA support ARM64? If your answer was yes, that's absolutely correct. And how to install OSA using GUI? Just the three simple steps. Download the ISO, boot the computer using the ISO file, and follow the instructions on the GUI. Now, let's do a quick comparison as to what was better. Was A better, the chunky piece of content, or was B better, which was modularized and minimalized? Now, according to a software documentation perspective, we would definitely want to go with B scenario, which was the content was modularized and minimalized, due to which it was you were able to find answers to those two questions a lot faster in situation B rather than situation A. Now, how is it that we know that the piece of content that we will be testing is, or rather should be, modularized or minimalized? Now, here is a content review workflow that I usually follow, and this is something that I've come up with. It's completely made up. As you can see, the pattern expanding. However, I call it the ARVR model. ARVR model standing for audience. Firstly, you ask yourself two questions here. Okay, firstly, who are the audience and can they do it? When we ask who are the audience, what we mean to say is, are they system administrators? Are they users? Are they root users? What kind of a role do they have? Okay, can they do it? Okay, is a user supposed to have privileges to do the task of a system administrator? No. In that particular case, you need to identify your audience correctly. Going forth, you need to understand the audience's requirement by asking questions like, what is the end goal? What are the end goals for the audience? Why is it that they want to perform a procedure, or they want to read a piece of content from a software documentation? What is their end goal there? Alongside that, you also need to understand why they are reading this, to understand their end goal a little more better. Now, when we talk about installing an operating system, there might be multiple factors involved into it, like downloading the operating system or maybe using PXE servers, things like that. Okay, so you need to understand the exact crux of their end goal and understanding why they are reading that piece of content. Next one is verification. You need to verify whether the content is valid and accurate at any given point of time. You also need to look at improvement areas so that the you need to look at improvement areas or identify improvement areas so that the content can be made better. Alongside verification, the last one is the reader's experience, which is a major, major goal, especially looking at the very short attention span that our current readers usually have. Okay, need to see to it whether the content was easily understandable, and did it achieve the end goal. So these are the questions you can ask yourself when you're trying to review a piece of content that has been done for a software or perhaps a hardware or anything from an IT industry. This is a very basic approach on how you can test the content to make sure that it's user-friendly, that it meets its end goal, and it's valid and accurate. That being said, I would like to wrap it up. This is all from me. I am open to questions. I am available right here after this video ends. And well, thank you all for attending.
All right. Thank you so much, Pratik, for the talk. Audience, if you have any questions, please feel free to put them in the chat. And Pratik, would you be joining us on camera to answer the questions? Yes. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Karan, and thank you everyone for joining. I'm really sorry about the audio quality on the video. This is actually my first time recording and editing a video for a virtual conference. Okay. Thank you, Sally. Okay, Karan, I guess there are no questions. If there are none, I'd just like to take a quick moment to thank you, the DevConf US organizing team, for hosting this conference virtually for the first time. And so far it's been great. I hope to see something similar, or rather a better version of this in the near future.
Yeah, of course. And also, audience, if anyone has any questions that have not been answered already, then you can also head over to the breakout room, the link to which I just posted. And hopefully Pratik can hang out in the breakout room for a little while and answer all of your questions. All right. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Great day ahead.